What is going on, guys? It's Waffle here. I almost just bashed myself in the head with a chainsaw right there. But anyways, welcome back to some more Scorched Earth. Now, last time we left off, we were testing out our brand new flamethrower that we made. We made some ammo for it. A little bit of flamethrower ammo. Only one thing of it, and, just killed a random amount of stuff. Even killed a T-Rex, but unfortunately, after killing that T-Rex, we got murdered by a BA Sabertooth. Well, we got knocked out by the BA Sabertooth. The BA Sabertooth, BA Poison Sabertooth, to be more specific, ended up killing our Jerry the Jerboa that was on our shoulder, the male Jerry. We made a grave for him and everything, and, well, I don't know. I've been reading you guys' comments. I don't know if I really need another Jerboa right now, but, like, we do have some pretty good armor, pretty good fortitude by now. If we do get, like, a heat wave or anything like that, it's not really the biggest deal in the universe, we could survive heat waves, we could survive, thunderstorms and stuff pretty well these days, so I don't know if we should get a Jerboa next. I saw you guys commenting saying, hey, why don't you get yourself a vulture? That way, it's kind of like a Dimorphodon where it's going to be able to do damage and whatnot compared to Jerboa. That's just kind of sitting there making little noises whenever a storm's a brewing and whatnot. So I guess maybe this episode we could try and tame a vulture and try and get ourselves, a companion that can, help us out in battles and stuff. So anyways, oh yeah, and also got some comments about that cave over there saying that you can get critters to follow you into the cave, and that's how you can get, that's how you can ride them into there. Maybe you can get them to follow you past that little point of no return or whatever that thing is where it's like blocking the Sabertooth and the Direwolf and all that other critters we try to, get past that little invisible barrier. But I suppose we can make them follow us, and maybe that's going to get us to get an animal in there. Also got some comments saying they make some bug repellent and stuff, so that's going to help out with the Arthropleurus. I don't know if I have that unlocked, so let's see. We have bug repellent, so I assume we can make some of this. Can we make it here in the chemistry table? Here in the chemistry table, bug repellent. Yep, there is right there. I assume we can make a pretty good amount of that. Let's pull resources. X10, not enough resources. Okay, we probably need some narcotics, citronals. Yeah, citronals and rockerets. It looks like we need some of those. So let's go check about our farm. Didn't we plant down? No. We never planted down rockerets, did we? I know we have citronals because we. There's a little Jerboa right there, making me think of a. Oh yeah, we do have a long grass here. Do we have? There's citronal. This is Savaroots, right? Yeah, we don't have and this is Miho Bear. Yeah, this is Miho Bears. Yeah, we don't have rockerets, do we? Yeah, we should probably make one or two more extra things right there and plant down some rockerets. Ah, man. Well, it's just reminding me of the two Jerboas we had. Now, I know that Jerry, the female Jerboa, didn't technically die. Just kind of went missing and despawned inside that cave, but she's still gone, She might as well be dead, right? Well, anyways. Let's see, what all do we need for that? I think we need rocks and stuff for a large plant thing. Do we have stone over here? We have a little bit of stone. I think we might need to get on the rock over here and break ourselves some stone and whatnot. That's going to hopefully get... Hey, you guys saw over there, I got a lot of, what's it called? The cactus sap? I got a lot of the cactus sap. Started making a lot of propellants, so hopefully we can get ourselves more flamethrower fuel. Hopefully, like, if we get in another battle like that one time we got in a battle with that Sabertooth, hopefully we'll still have enough ammo to, burn that Sabertooth alive instead of getting completely murdered and ransacked by it. Even though I think it did hit us, like, once. And, let me just drop some of the sand. I think it hit us, like, once and we got insta-knocked out from that, so we need to watch out for that stuff next time. Anyways, we have 3,000 stamina, 10,000 health, 1,500 carry weight, 300% melee damage, 150% movement speed. I don't know what I want. Maybe more carry weight. There we go. Get that up to like 2,000 or something like that. That sounds pretty good. Let's just grab all the stone out of his inventory and just kind of move it using the resource puller. God, just took a little... Oh, there's the little Common Rex bone helmet right there that Jerry wore whenever he died. Ah, man. All these reminders. There's like noises going on outside too. You guys need to ignore that. Hopefully it's not showing up on the mic though. Anyways, let's pull. Oh my god, we have 1,000 rocks! Yeah, there's no wonder we don't have any room there. Jeez! Let's see if we can pull them over into here, because there's a lot of room here, as well as a, whatever that thing is over there. I almost called it a smeltery, but that's not quite it, is it? It's a, Man, I can't remember what it's called. Where's the stone at on this? Jeez, did I forget my alphabet all of a sudden? Jeez, there you go. Oh, that's sulfur. Oh, there you go. I'm feeling super off today. There you go. 1,020 in there. Let's just think of smithy. There you go. That's what it's called. All right, so we need rocks, we need wood, and we need thatch, I believe. We have a lot of thatch because I got a lot of... I was over there, you know, grinding down cacti with a chainsaw, so we got a lot of thatch. As well, a little bit of wood, so let's grab some of that. I don't think we have any more wood over here, but we only need like two large crop plots. So there you go. Let's grab a crop plot. What else do we need for the fiber? Okay, let's grab a little bit of fiber. I think we have a lot over here because I just transferred a lot of it to repair my armor that broke because, you know, we died last episode. Anyways, let's see. Large. There you go. Large crop plot. Oh, let's get the S+ ones. Yeah. I like the S+ ones because they snap to the foundation and ceilings. I don't know why I need to snap the ceilings and whatnot, but whatever, that's kind of helpful, I suppose. And it was just put up the extra stone that we don't need and thatch and all that stuff. I suppose we could put up, thatch in the thatch chest. Might as well, right? What are you doing over here, chef? You still cooking? Yep, there you go. Looks like all that's pretty much done. A little bit of raw meat there, but I'm not really complaining. Hey, let's make sure that spark powder doesn't get wasted. Anyways, let's put up all the extra thatch and all that stuff. And we can put up all this and hopefully grab ourselves a flamethrower fuel, craft ourselves more flamethrower fuel, head back to that cave, see if we can explore it. And see if we can also tame a vulture, too. Now, I think vultures get tamed, like, mainly by spoiled meat. So let's go over here. I think that's, like, technically the prime meat of vultures. So we still have a lot of spoiled meat. So there you go. And we passively tame them. I know we tried to tame one earlier into the series. Like, one of the first few episodes, we tried to tame one of those bad boys. Oh, yeah. Flamethrower fuel. Let's go over here and try and craft some of that stufferoo. Where is it? Oh, there's it there. Flamethrower ammo. We can make six of that. Oh, gee, look at how fast we can make that. Man, I'm not complaining, Hayda. Oh, yeah, we need rockeret seeds, too. Let's go get some rockeret seeds and a little bit of fertilizer if I still have some rocket. Let me see. I'm gonna make it a little bit easier. There you go, rockeret seeds. We only need one of them, technically, but, do we want to plant, like, narcoberries or something? Let's plant some more narcoberries on the second plot that we're going to lay down. So there you go. Do we have fertilizer in this one? Usually I keep fertilizer in here, or maybe there's fertilizer in one of these preserving bins. Yep, there you go, fertilizer right there. Art compost bin, not preserve. I guess technically it preserves poop, right? Alright, let's head back to our farm. I still need to extend this area past the greenhouse, make it a little bit bigger, because I've been getting comments from you guys for a while now, saying, hey, your area's getting kind of small, Hayda. You're getting a lot of dinos, and they don't really have too much room to roam around, so I definitely do need to, extend it here, most likely off camera, because I don't want to waste a bunch of time on camera with me doing basically just crafting and placing things down, right? Anyways, let's get the up there is rocket seat, and because this is this water working above it, it should. Yep, look at that. It's got irrigation. Perfect. You can see they're starting to sprout a little bit, which is crazy because that wouldn't happen in real life that fast, right? Anyways, let's go find ourselves a vulture and see if we can tame one of those bad boys. Anyways, let's get on. Who should we? Let's try our Alpha Utahraptor. That guy is powerful as heck. He's fast as heck. If he follows us inside the place, then that would be super duper helpful. Anyways, I don't know if a vulture can, like, wear anything, but if we do tame a vulture, I kind of want to make it wear the T-Rex bone helmet skin thing that we gave our little Jerry the Jerboa, the male Jerboa, so that way, you know, he's kind of protected a little bit, and he kind of has a cool hat, and it's kind of in remembrance of Jerry the male Jerboa, who was only with us for less than 10 episodes. Alpha Dodo. Oh, baby, turn this way. There you go. That's a tameable Alpha Dodo, you guys.
I totally want to tame one. Oh my god.
I totally want to tame one. We do have trank arrows, right? Yeah, we have trank arrows with our crossbow. How much torpor did it have? Now, because this is Alpha, 4,000 torpor. That's going to be kind of tough. I don't know, you guys. We might want to tame that thing a little bit later. Let's try and tame ourselves like a vulture or something first. Get out of the way there, you piece of trash, Meritops. Let's go, out here to the sand dunes. See if we can find ourselves. Oh, Mantis is right there chasing a Gallimimus as well as a Titanobo, too. That's crazy. Alright, oh! I think. No, those are junk bugs. Yeah, there's the junk bugs there. Yep, I see a vulture, though. What level is that? I kind of want to get a higher level one. It's, even though, of course, the higher level it is, level 95. That's pretty good. Level 95, that's a... Oh, what's that noise? Sounds like a Prime Alpha or Alpha something. Oh, there it is right there. Prime Alpha Dilophosaurus. 113,000 health. You kidding me? You kidding me? We were just killing things with that much health in our other arcs. There's no way we're going to be taming that bad boy. Okay, there's a level 10 vulture. Where's that level 90? Yeah, here we go, level 95. But it is kind of close to that prime alpha Dilophosaurus. Oh man, I don't know if we can tame that. Look at how close it is to the Dilophosaurus though. I think we, oh, chuck bug, ugh. Okay, we should probably wait around a little bit. Should we wait around a little bit for that vulture to either fly away or get farther away from that prime alpha? Seems like he's getting, oh, the prime alpha. Oh. Oh, does he know? Does he know? Oh, jeez. Oh, man. I think we're good. I think we're good. Woo! Okay, you know what? Let's keep going around a bit. It's kind of dangerous here. I don't know if we're really risking for that level 95 vulture. It is a pretty high level. But to, oh, yeah, there's another vulture right there. I don't know. What is that? Titanomyrmer? Yeah, the Titanomyrmer's over there. What about this one? Level 78. Level 78 female. What? Oh, what about that one? Level 89 female. Ooh, that's pretty good. Or is that prime alpha? Seems like he's still somewhat close to the vulture over there. Let's see, what about that one over there? Level 41 female. They have 340 torpor. You do need to passively tame these. So, I don't know if it's oh my god, they're trying to attack the scorpion? Oh, yep, they're attacking the scorpion. Okay, we should probably watch out for that here in a bit. But we are, like, right next to this church-looking thing, so let's get our Alpha Utah. Oh, jeez, it's attacking me. What are you doing, you piece of trash? Yeah, you're going to get killed by the Alpha Utahraptor now, you garbage. Look at you, kill the vultures. Kill the insanely high-leveled vultures. Eh, just under level 100. It's not insanely high-leveled, but... Man, would have been great if we could tame them. Man, they started attacking me. Can you come in here, Alpha Utahraptor? Looks like it, you guys. Look at this. Can he fit in this, though? It is kind of a small little thing. I did have to crouch, I think. So, is he going to glitch? Yeah, it seems like he can't do it. But we can ride him. I don't know if... Can we break this? I don't know if we can or not. Yeah, it seems like it's indestructible, so... Yeah, I don't think we can... Huh. What if I got, like, a smaller critter? Like a dire... I don't know. I don't know if, like, a dire wolf, like Scout or anyone, would still be able to fit in this. If I can't fit in it, I'm like, I do have gigantic meaty arms and stuff, right? Jeez! But I have to crouch to go under that, you see? I can't just walk normally under it. I have to do the little duck walk. Huh. I don't know. I might want to come back here with, like, Scout or some other rideable critter that's somewhat small. That's harsh to flesh. Might as well, right? Get some swallowed meat and stuff. Let's see how far away that... Level 95 or whatever it is from the Prime Alpha. Seems like he's like right next to it. Are you kidding me? Let's see. Zoom in. Is that the one? Is that the one I'm looking at? Yeah, level 95 female. Oh my god. Get away from the Prime Alpha, you stupid. Jeez. I guess it is kind of smart. Anything that comes in contact with that Prime Alpha is going to die, and that vulture is going to be taking its pickings hardcore. There's a vulture right there. Alright, it seems like it's somewhat far away. We might want to get some of the ghillie stuff, maybe sneak up on the vulture. That might be the best course of action. There's the dire wolf right there, or, Dilophosaurus, it's like right next to it. You kidding me? You kidding me? Okay, what about that vulture? Jeez, I'm just over here trying to tame a wolf level 10. Oh, it's kind of far away though. There's a 95 vulture, okay. You guys, let's try and tame it. It's flying like towards the Prime Alpha. I don't know why. It's kind of... Just get over here. There's a regular Velociraptor or a... Cat? Dilophosaurus. Okay, we might want to sneak up on these bad boys. I don't know which one's which. There's the Prime Alpha. I do want to stay away from it. Jeez. Come on. Which one is it? Is it that? It's got to be that one, right? Come on. No, that's a level 10, so it must be this one then, right? Line 95. Yep, 95. Okay. Come over here. Let's try and tame it. We do have Prime Alpha. Or, spoiled meat. In the taming slot. Oh, we can stop flying towards the Prime Alpha, you piece of trash. Oh, dung beetle, vulture, land on the ground. I just want to tame you. I'm a harmless little meaty fellow, chef. That's all I am. I'm over here trying to tame you, trying to feed you. That's all I'm trying to do. Try to sneak up on him. I'm a living being, so you're not going to try and eat my flesh. Female vulture. Feed spoiled meat. There you go. Oh, the Prime Alpha. How are we doing on taming? Oh, only a couple more things till it gets tamed. Oh my god. Look at how close it is. Wait till it's hungry. I know. It's 47 levels. It's going to be... Oh. It's not going to attack me. Oh. I'm trying to feed you there, buddy, Obalo Vulture. Come on. Here's the Alpha Utahraptor. I want to head back home. I'm like, we will have our... I don't think I'm ready for the cave just yet. I still need to make the bug repellent. But there's the Vulture. Let's wait for it to land on the ground again. Wait for it to land on the ground again. Trying to... Oh. And then give it... Oh, no. Still, it's still not hungry just yet. There's the Prime Alpha over there. Come on. Oh, it's not hungry just yet. It just pooped. Jeez. Okay. There's a Prime Alpha over there. Still need to watch out for it. Need to be careful. There's a pink slash purple. It's feet spawning meat. Come on. We had it there.
How in the world is it, like, not getting, like... I'm a huge critter over here. I just called myself a critter. I'm a huge meaty chef. And it doesn't see me coming over here trying to feed it.
Okay, come on. It's ready to eat. It was like halfway tamed. Hopefully the tamer didn't go down. There we go. Okay, one more thing of spoiled meat and I've got it, you guys. So I think I'm going to pause the recording, wait for it to be hungry again, and I guess I'll feed it some more spoiled meat and hopefully get this bad boy tamed to us. It is going to be like level 140 something by the time it's tamed, so I am really excited for us to finally have another companion that's at least going to be able to survive pretty well. In the hostile environment that we're living in here in Scorched Earth, you know, it's going to be more utility than Jerry ever was. I'd hate to say it, but their little weather notifications is helpful. But this is going to help out tremendously in combat, so I'm going to try and tail this vulture some more, wait for it to get hungry, feed it, and hopefully we're going to get this thing tamed to us, and I'll see you guys here in a bit.
Okay, guys, I'm ready to tame it. It is hungry again.
Just keep sneaking up on this vulture. We just need to wait for it to at least get close to the ground. Don't necessarily have to wait for it to land. Oh, there it is right there. It just pooped. Man, that's like three times. It's pooped like three times in the past minute. Oh god, scorpion. Okay, flamethrower time. Oh no. It's going to fight him. Where's the flamethrower at? Oh man, I put it up. Oh god. Okay, we have the chainsaw though. Hopefully the vulture is going to be able to kill the scorpion. What level is the scorpion? Scorpion's actually going down quickly. Jeez, look at that. Look at the vulture. Man, look at that thing kill the scorpion. Holy, the vulture's basically full health. Look at that, and it's flying away. It's getting a little bit of torpor on it. You should definitely watch out for that, though. But us, we need to wait for the scorpion to hopefully... Oh, God, it's coming. It's coming over here. Oh, God. This is not good. Okay, there's a scorpion right there. I don't really have any projectiles. I should probably get some of the stimulants right now and try and keep myself awake so I don't get knocked out by this thing, but it is getting away from the vulture, which is good. Let's try and tame it. Sneak up on it. Come on. Where's the... Scorpion's gone. Vulture. And... Oh, God. One more. What? How many more? Oh, God. There's the scorpion. Oh, jeez. Okay. Chainsaw time. Hater. Oh, it's fighting him. It's fighting the vulture. Come on. Kill the scorpion. Kill it, you piece of trash. Jeez. I just want to tame you. That's all I want. Man, this taming wasn't... Oh, God, he's coming over here now. Oh, God. I'm killing the vulture. Oh, God, I killed the vulture. And the scorpion chase. Man, you kidding me? Why was it... Oh, man. It's probably because I wasn't sneaking right there. I wasn't being a sneaky little chef. Oh, jeez, we had that thing tamed, and it came over here and attacked us. Okay, I need to find another vulture. Man. I know that wearing, like, ghillie and stuff, ghillie armor is going to make you a little bit more, sneaky, and it blend in a little bit more, and it won't be able to see you quite as well, but...
The blur's over there.
But, I guess I'm just going to have to ride around here in our Alpha Utahraptor, see if we can find another...
Oh, there's a vulture right there.
See if we can find another high-level vulture. That's a level 4. That's literally trash. we got jug bugs and...
Dung beetles and... Railtops.
Gamblesaurus. If that's what you want to call them. Scorpifellow.
I don't really see any more vultures, though.
There's another vulture right there. Level 14. Pretty high on torpor, though.
Man, it's getting dark, too. Really need to watch out for this.
Okay, well, I think I'm going to pause the recording, see if we can find another one, and I will see you guys here in a bit, right before we hopefully tame one, so...
I don't know, should we... what level's that one, though? There's a Prime Alpha. That one's level 41.
I know, I'm probably getting, like, tons of comments right now saying I'm dumb... breakfast food over here for not taming that level 94 or whatever that was.
And there's a Dodo Rex. What? Oh my god. We need to watch.
We need to watch out for that bad boy now. Jeez, look at that casual notorexy. Man.
Okay, well, it is nighttime right now. I need to be really careful. In the deserts of scorched earth.
So I'm going to pause the recording. I might want to wait it out for morning time, but I'm going to scatter out here. See if I can find another vulture. See if I can try and passively tame it. And I will see you guys here in a bit. All right, guys, I'm back. And I just tamed this vulture right here. Oh, yep. There we go. Capture that bat. Oh, what does that look like on my shoulder? Ooh, that is so cool. Man, I wish I had tanned a vulture sooner. Okay. Oh, can you kill that Titanomyrma? Kill it. Kill it. Kill it. Kill it. Oh, stop following me there. There you go. I wonder how I can get this thing to, hold on. I think I might need to check the settings here. Let me casually check some vulture settings. Pick up, blah, blah, blah. I need to set the aggression to aggressive. There we go. Ooh. And then, can I launch this thing at the Titanomyrma? Is it going to start attacking it? Doesn't seem like it. Okay. Is it aggressive? It should be. Yeah, aggression is... maybe stop following... Oh, wait. Stop following me. There you go. Aggression neutral. Let me set that back to... Let me set that back to aggressive. Get over... Oh, God. We're, like, right next to a Dodorexy. We need to watch out. There you go. Aggression is aggressive. I assume now she's going to start, attacking things, but maybe she's not going to attack that Titanomyrma because it's so tiny and piece of trash. Anyways, there's a Dodorexy right there. We need to watch out. Hardcore. Okay. Let's head back home. I don't know if our rockers are, you know, growing or anything. They are inside of a greenhouse, so they should be able to grow pretty fast, but I don't think they're going to be done just yet. Spent literally all night trying to tame a Dodorexy. Or, not a Dodorexy, but a vulture. And we finally got one. Like I said, I think it was like level 116 or something, whenever I was taming it. So we got a pretty good level bonus. Now that we're a little bit farther away from all the hostiles, let's look at our brand new vulture. What does this thing look like? It just looks like a regular old vulture, if you ask me. Level 174, I assume. Yeah, it's got some level ups. Let's give some more health right there. 300% melee damage? Oh, man, that's crazy. Oh, wait, can I give it, like, a hat? I can. Ooh. Oh, wait, I can give it a costume, but I can't give it a hat. Yeah, I can't put that inside of its inventory. I can give it some spoiled meat so we can start eating some. Okay, yeah, you can take all the spoiled meat. I don't care. I don't need that trash. Let's see. Let's give you some more health. There you go. Give you some more health, because you already have an absolutely insane amount of melee damage. Okay, so should we come over here and try and tame that Alpha Dodo? Come back with our, I'm thinking here either the Direwolf or the... I think the Sabertooth is better than the Direwolf in terms of, you know, like, not mocking things out, but knocking things out. Let's go get our Sabertooth, our brand new, Poison BA Sabertooth. Not the one that killed us, like, last episode or something, but the one that we tamed, like, a couple episodes ago. So, let's head back home. Now that we have ourselves a brand new companion in terms of this vulture, I'm going to need to make another, naming episode here pretty soon, which, by the way, I do need to check upon you guys' names. I've just been, like, really busy lately. I know I probably said I was going to do it this episode, but, God, I've just been so busy lately trying to make these videos, trying to upload, and then trying to have a life, too, you know? So it's kind of hard to try and do all that stuff and try and find time for literally looking through hundreds of comments to find names and stuff. So, yeah, I'm going to get to it eventually, but at least I have all you guys' comments on that video to check through, so it's going to be kind of easy to do that. Anyways, let's see. I don't think we have any costumes in this series, right? So I don't think I can give you anything there, little vulture friend. I guess I could give you the spoiled meat. Oh yeah, let's get the flamethrower. Where'd I put the flamethrower? Is it inside of here? Oh, there it is right there. Why'd I put it inside? I don't know why. Huh. Okay, well, let's put the flamethrower, probably don't need that metal hatchet right now, to be quite honest. Let's get the flamethrower. There you go. Oh, look at this bad boy. I got myself a flame with a rower hater. Let's go find ourselves the Poison BA Sabertooth. There it is right there. Let's go find ourselves let's go tame ourselves the... Oh, yeah, let's go get ourselves a prime meat, too. I guess we could probably kill a couple things, get ourselves prime meat on the way there, right? Let's go try and tame that Alpha Dodo. That's going to be crazy to get. It's going to be our first Alpha Dodo of this... I was about to say our first Alpha of the tame. Not first Alpha of the dead, that makes no sense. Our first Alpha of the series, but we literally have an Alpha Utahraptor we just rode on, and of course the Alpha RG, so it's not going to be the first Alpha of the series or anything, but we should be able to get ourselves a pretty good amount of meat from this female Brawltops. Level 62, ooh, I wonder, actually, because let me kill this thing, actually, because apparently the vulture is supposed to be able to harvest flesh and whatnot, and harvest it pretty well. Oh my god, there's so many Brawltops over here trying to save the day. Yeah, you guys are getting knocked out too, hater. Look at that, the vulture's harvesting the Brawltops. Oh wait, it killed the Brawltops. Ooh, nice. That's helpful. So there you go. Can you harvest a flash? Harvest a flash. I don't know if...
Yeah, oh, I think it harvested a flash. Let me actually check. Oh, that's the wrong inventory. There's a lava source right there. Let me try and kill that piece of trash. Yeah, I knocked out that thing. Good thing it's not the Prime Alpha or anything, right? I'll never be able to knock that thing out. You can't knock out Prime Alphas. Fun little fact. Let's see, how much meat do you have? Because apparently you're really good at, Yeah, look at that spoil is in 44 minutes. How long is it meat spoil in my inventory? Like 3 minutes or something. Yeah, look at that. It's crazy. So, meat inside of the Vulture's inventory. Which, by the way, it looks like the Vulture got another level up. Let's give us... I don't know why I gave it stamina right there. It's not like it's going anywhere, right? But I probably should have gave it health. But apparently, it's able to, like, keep food from spoiling, like, 4 times better than normal, which is really good. Anyways, our Sabertooth got itself some level ups, too. Let's see. What do we want to give it? Maybe some more... Let's give it some more movement speed. There you go. Get that up a little bit. I probably should have gave it some carry weight, too. But let's try and knock out and tame that Alpha... Dodo up here. We didn't get any prime meat from those bad boys, but just regular old meat should be able to tame the thing pretty easily. It is an alpha, so don't think we're going to need a sedative narcotic or anything to tame it. So let's see, where was it? It was over here, wasn't it? There's a kangaroo. Oh, there's right there the alpha dodo. Look at that regular old dodo right there, too. Alpha dodo, that thing looks crazy. Let's try and knock this thing out and tame it. Come on, come on, come on, don't kill it there, Vulture, don't kill it. Oh, it's run away from Torpor already. Ooh, it's unconscious, nice! Look at that! So good. Don't kill it, Vulture. I hope you're not like my Dimorphodon where you start attacking things when I get too close to it. Anyways, there you go. The Torpor on it is going down pretty quickly. We need to give it some more narcotics. There you go. Give us some more narcotics. Yeah, look at how fast the Torpor's going, but the food is also going down pretty quickly as well. Hold on. It might need prime meat. I think it is one of those critters where it only gets tamed by prime meat. Ooh, I need to watch out for this, you guys. Let's go try and, I don't know. We need to go kill like a baby or a juvenile something, because those things always drop so much prime meat. But, let's see. It's going to be kind of hard to find those, because the babies are, of course, always going to be tiny. Oh! That's a regular glove sword right there. Piece of trash. What is that? Is that a baby or something? Oh, adolescent. Okay, let's kill it. Harvest of flesh. 9 prime meat. I don't know if that is that enough? I don't know if that's enough. I might want to kill the regular glove swords right here, too. See if we can get ourselves a prime meat off of this thing. Piece of trash. I don't know how good the Sabertooth is at harvesting like prime meat and whatnot. Yeah, I didn't get a single bit of prime meat right there. I always get comments saying, hey, stop killing babies and adolescents and stuff like that. No, the alpha dog. God, what? Mantis? Oh, you piece of trash. I'm gonna kill you. I'm gonna kill you. Oh, look at that. Ugh. Okay, let's kill this thing. I don't care. I'm not looking to tame a mantis right now, but Mantis. I really wanted to tame that thing. Oh, my. Why does everything always happen like that? I don't know. Man. I could always revert my save and whatnot, like you guys always comment, but I'm only going to revert my save for, like, special instances, like, where the game, like, glitches out and stuff like that. I'm not just going to revert the save just because I didn't tame what I wanted, you know?